Well, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Today I'm doing some inverter testing and I thought, why not bring you along? This is an inverter that I built my whole garage with up at my camp. And I had one battery, a deep cycle battery, and this inverter. This is a 3000 watt inverter and it peaks out to 6000 watts. And of course I had it hooked up to a one wire alternator and my two-cylinder diesel Kubota engine. I'll see if I can throw a picture at the end here of it. Now I've disassembled this all, and if you've been watching my videos for a long time, in the beginning I showed me starting it up after about a year of sitting around the side of my garage, and I'm gonna have to do it again this year as well. So what this vid is all about is I'm testing this power inverter to see if I can use it up at my camp. And because recently you could see in my previous videos, I bought some solar panel kit. It's a 400 watt solar panel kit. And I'm gonna be able to have a little more power now. So I thought maybe I would upgrade to this inverter that I have here, which is a lot more powerful. Now, like right now, I'm running my whole camp off of a 400 watt inverter. So this would be a big difference. And what I have to do is I have to actually test it first. And we'll get into that right next. But first I'm gonna show you the little booklet that it has, and you're gonna get a laugh out of this, because guess what? When you buy these inverters and they come from offshore, you might as well just take the manuals and chuck them right in the garbage, because they're not worth nothing. You pretty much have to test before you put anything into service. And that's what I do. So let's get to it right now. Well, what we're looking at here is the factory manual. I got it zoomed in there pretty good, but what I want to show you, what I'm testing today, is the no load current draw. So as you can see, the bottom one is 2 amp and the top one is 1 amp. Now mine is the modified sine wave, which is 1 amp, and the other one is a pure sine wave, which is 2 amps. So I'm looking for 1 amp. So let's just take a look at the next page. Okay, so this one here is the spec that comes off their website, and they're saying right there the no load draw you can see is 0.2 amp at 12 volt. So let's go to the next page. So here's the manual right here. Position of the power inverter. The unit was designed so it can be placed in a drink holder. In a drinks holder. So I found that pretty interesting. This goes into a drinks holder. Well, I thought that was cute. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed that. And so now you know what I'm testing for. I'm testing for the no load amperage draw. And that's very important, because when you're not using it, how much does it actually use? And that makes a big difference, especially when, you know, it's dark at night and you're not producing any power, or if it's on a cloudy day, if the amperage draw is too high, well, you're just going to drain your batteries. And the one that I have up at the camp now is about 0.3. So say about a third of an amp, at the most a half an amp an hour draw. So let's test this one here and let's see what it draws, because they're saying, like, it's kind of confusing, but they're saying 1 amp. It looks like it's going to be 1 amp, and 2 amp if it's a modified, I'm sorry, it's a 2 amp if it's a pure sine wave inverter, and 1 amp if it's a modified sine wave inverter. And this one here is a modified sine wave inverter. So let's test. Well, what are we looking at right here? Okay, so I've got my meter on the right, and that's going to show you the amp draw. I've zeroed out my clamp meter, and on the far left, you can see the voltage of the battery, 12.8. So let's put the clamp meter on over both of the cables. There's 2 black and 2 red. So I want to test both of them at the same time, and let's take a look and see what the reading is. Okay, so she's around now. Let's turn the unit on. And guys, you could see the spike that it went up to. I hope you can see that. It spiked up to 20 amps when I first turned it on. And that's because it's got capacitors inside. And that's why you don't want to try this with your meter, because it'll probably blow your fuse. And it looks like it's around 4.9. Now that is much higher than what they were talking about. They're talking about 1. So that's way out of line as far as I'm concerned. And if we were to just like put it on one cable, there's 2.8 for one. And the other one is, say, 2. So let's go with the smaller clamp meter. And let's just take a look at that one and see what kind of reading we get off of that. Well, I got you pretty well zoomed in there. And I'll just show you the meter here. There it is. And she's pretty much zeroed out as much as you really need. You don't got to be that perfect. But let's put it on and let's take a look and see. Okay. See if I got everything in the shot there. And let's start it up. See if I can turn this light on. Now I'm seeing 2.8, which is 2.7, which is consistent with the other meter. And let's take it off here, put it on this side. So it's very consistent. So it's 2. So we're talking 4 amps, a little bit more than 4 amps while this thing is running, and probably closer to 5. So that's incredible. Well, it does not look like I'm going to be using that inverter up at the camp. It draws way too much. Like, we're talking about 5 amps, you know, over a 24-hour period. No. That just wouldn't be acceptable. Now, this does have a remote for it where you can turn it off and you can turn it on. But guess what? You're never going to remember all the time to be turning this thing off and on and off and on every time you want to use it. And, yeah, so I don't know what I'm going to do with this inverter. I'm going to probably set it up as a standalone system where I can power something if I want here and there, and then just charge it up when I want to. But if you guys like to see more of this inverter testing, let me know. I do this stuff all the time. I build stuff with you know, small solar panels and inverters and this kind of stuff for off-grid places. And my friends have these off-grid places. So thanks for joining me here today. If you've never seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. You guys let me know if you'd like to see more inverter testing and this kind of stuff, because it's cold here and it's the middle of the winter, and I like planning all this stuff for the spring. And I'm glad I tested this out, because yeah, if I would have just stuck this in there, my batteries go flat in no time. So thanks for joining me here today, and come back again. Let's have some more fun.